Did you know that over 6,000 ministry leaders joined us from Vine and Branches in Atlanta last spring to discover how the entire family ministry team can make the most out of every stage of a child's life as they grow from preschool to high school? You might be thinking about, what is this orange stuff I've been hearing about? Well, let me tell you about it. When we think about the two colors that make orange, yellow and red, we think of those two things as the church and the family. And when we bring those together, we make the color orange, or engaging church and family to influence the faith and character of the next generation. Reggie Joyner, the founder of Orange, years ago was an exuberant youth leader in a mega church that hundreds of youth that would come to his groups. And students would come to those groups, participate, and seemed very engaged, only to find out that after high school and after college, many of these grown children had left the church. Still today, 60% of children who regularly attend church with their families end up leaving the church when they leave home. Reggie felt called to do something about this and to support churches and families to make the connection stick. One way to tackle this as a church community is to engage children and families to understand that within the church walls, we cannot do it all. It is a time out in the mission fields of our homes, schools, and ball fields that we will practice our faith and support parents and teachers. Did you know that as Sunday school small group leaders, we only have around 40 hours a year to engage students in their faith? But as family members, we have over 3,000 hours to touch the lives of our children in faith. How we spend those precious hours each week, both in Sunday school and at home, needs to be intentional. As parents, how are we spending those 3,000 hours at home? Let me tell you, in our family, I figure at least 600 of those hours a year are spent in the car, driving our children to and from activities. But we have to be intentional about those hours and how we develop their faith. It is the goal of our church to support parents like you, as well as our family, to use this time as we engage and influence the faith and character of our children so that they are successful in the next generation. Reggie did an amazing job at this Orange Conference to describe each phase of a child's life. And we take that to heart here at Vine and Branches Sunday School to embrace the preschool age, to engage the elementary phase, to affirm in middle school, and to mobilize in high school. As parents, do you ever feel like the days are long, but the weeks fly by? We are all so busy, our family included, and we are encouraged to take time to look at each phase before they are gone. For example, if you have a fifth grader, they have about 312 weeks. That's 312 Sundays, 312 weekends until graduation. How are we going to leverage that time for God's purpose? In Sunday school, we're going to be focusing on strategies to support each one of these phases through small groups and for us as parents to continue at home. Because Jesus said, "Whoever welcomes one of these little ones in my name welcomes me." Why are we doing this? Because every child is made in the likeness and image of God. It is our purpose and intention here at Vine and Branches to use the Orange philosophy to implement the world curriculum, to use it through engagement, and to leverage the time we have with our students to share God's love. And I'm going to leave you with one last thought. What if children do not need more lessons, but they need more leaders? This for me is ever more important as our children experience the achievement culture. It is about a connection and a way to grow a child's faith and character for years to come.
In this time of desperation, when all we know is doubt and fear, there is only one foundation we believe. We believe. We believe in God the Father. We believe in Jesus Christ. We believe in the Holy Spirit, and He's given us new life. We believe in the crucifixion. We believe that He conquered death. We believe in the resurrection, and He's coming back again. We believe. So let our faith be more than anthems, greater than the songs we sing.